Mr. President, the Prime Minister of Israel is due any minute, and we've prepared a briefing for you.
I don't have to be briefed. I'm well acquainted with the importance of that valiant little nation, that bastion of freedom in the Middle East, and that large Jewish vote across this great land. But I'll talk to him anyway.
Well, Mr. President, it's not a him. The Prime Minister of Israel is Mrs. Golda Meir.
On the other hand, perhaps I ought to be briefed.
Anything you say, Mr. President.
Who's conducting the briefing, Jake Javits?
No, you'll be briefed by one of the most distinguished members of the Jewish community, and one hell of a singer, and here he is now.
Well, thank you, Mr. President. This is Uncle Georgie with the briefing.
Sir, would you start with some basic vocabulary? What should the president say when he greets Mrs. Meir?
Well, the proper Hebrew word for hello is shalom.
And the word for goodbye?
The word for goodbye, shalom.
How do I tell which is which?
Well, if she leaves after you've said it, you said goodbye.
That's quite interesting, of course. But you know, I happen to already know quite a few phrases of the Hebrew persuasion. For instance, I have been frequently told that I have a great deal of chutzpah.
That's chutzpah, sweetheart. Chutzpah. Mr. President, you should not offer Mrs. Meir ham or pork.
Why? Is she on a diet?
Look who I'm talking to. Mr. President, there are such things as dietary laws.
Of course. You forget that I lived in New York City. And if there's one thing that I learned, it's how people of the Hebrew persuasion eat. I'm going to take Mrs. Meir to a Chinese restaurant.
Mr. President, Mrs. Meir is here.
Bring her in. Shalim, Shalim, Shalo.
Madame Golda Meir.
Golda, sweetie.
Mrs. Meir, on behalf of the American people, Shamo.